Hey, what's up, folks? It's almost December, and you know what that means. Game of the Year discussions are just weeks away. So I've spent the past couple of weeks trying to play as many of the fantastic games that came out in 2015 to round out my own personal top 10 contenders. So in these videos, I'm going to talk about each game individually, say why it's great, why maybe it fell short. And this one, the first video, we're talking about Witcher 3 Wild Hunt. It's impossible to talk about The Witcher 3 Wild Hunt without talking about stories. It's a game of stories, and in that way, it's probably the best open-world role-playing game ever made. When you think about all the great experiences you have playing this game, you think about the botchling, all that bloody Baron stuff, the ladies in the woods, all the crazy side quests you sort of just bumped into, all those secondary quests, all those character quests which then bled into the secondary quests, and the main quest, and then the main quest itself, a really solid story the entire way out, which spans the entire map from the sort of small little area you start off in White Orchard to No Man's Land and Novigrad over to Skellige. And it's a fantastic main quest because it sort of gets you out into parts of the map where you can pick up side quests and secondary quests without being really that overbearing. It never felt like in other games, like, say, for instance, Fallout 3, at least in New Vegas, which were main quests, after a while you kind of felt like, oh, well, I shouldn't be doing side quests, I should finish this thing. That's not what The Witcher ever felt like. Combat in the game is great, especially if you play on harder difficulty. It can be a bit of a cakewalk if you play on easy, and it can feel very simplistic, at least in terms of the sort of the moment-to-moment action. It gets quite button-mashy, but if you play on a hard enough difficulty, and you have to consider things like your weapons, your armor, your oils, your toxicity, and what you're taking in terms of potions, it's a really deep and involved system. Of course, this is 2015, and when a game is out, it's not just out. It continues to be out for months going forward, and I think you can't really talk about The Witcher 3 Wild Hunt without tipping a hat to CD Projekt Red's fantastic post-game support, be it with the free DLC that they gave weeks after it was released, and also for Hearts of Stone, which is a fantastic expansion pack. But perhaps the jewel in The Witcher 3's crown is its incredible expansive world. From starting off in White Orchard and seeing the sort of intricate details of towns and people and houses and pubs, to the expansive city of Novigrad, which just looks incredible, especially on PC. No Man's Land, I don't know how they quite made a fucking swamp and a bunch of muddy fields look that good, but it looks incredible. And then Skellige, just the detail in these worlds, not just in terms of graphics, but in terms of audio, like all these wonderful accents from all over the world, which were translated into like 8 or 9 different languages for the global release of the game. Great detail in terms of the backstory and heritage of each place. Like, every place in The Witcher feels like a real place, and it feels kind of like the tide of war is almost this just inevitable thing that keeps happening. It's an incredible game because in so many games, especially games where you play someone powerful like Geralt of Rivia, you're just wandering into places and fixing their problems. And though the main quest is definitely a sort of heroic act that only Geralt and Ciri could possibly do, you never really felt like you were just going into places and solving people's problems. In fact, some of the time when you'd completed quests, even if you tried your best, the people were worse off. And I think that's perhaps The Witcher 3's most impressive asset, is that it's a fantastic game when it comes to storytelling, but it's also a game that makes you feel, it feels real because everything isn't just fucking rosy by the time you're finished a quest, or by the time the game ends, depending on what your choices are. Witcher 3 Wild Hunt, obviously one of the biggest contenders for Game of the Year of 2015, but it's not the only one, so stay tuned to youtube.com/DannyDwyer for more of my thoughts on some of the other fantastic games that came out in 2015.